Hi students, in this video we are going to learn some possible one mark question from chapter 1. So our first question, what is the least number that can be added to 1056 so that the number is divisible by 23? So what they are asking is, this number 1056 should be added with what number, then that number will come in 23 table they are asking. So very easily what we can do is, the 1056 just divided by 23. So 23 tables, so 1050. So here first we'll take this 105. 23 into 4 will give you 92. Just to do the subtraction, we will be getting 13 here. Next number you take it down, 6. Now 23 here we are getting 136. What should be added is a question. So we have to take the next number of 136. Because we need to make this number divisible by 23. So we need to reach the answer 0. So if you are getting 23 6 are, it's coming to 138. So definitely this 6 should be 8. Then only that number will become 0. So 136 should make it into 138. What should be added, they are asking. We need to add plus 2. Then only this number will become 138. That will come in 23 table to reach the 0. So plus 2 should be added. So that is your correct answer. 2 is the correct answer for the problem. We'll move on to the next problem now. So here comes our division lemma. Division lemma. So this is nothing but your dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. That is a rule. Actually dividend is given as A and our divisor is given as B. Quotient is Q and the remainder is R is given. So for this division, which rule is the correct rule they are asking? Our remainder should be greater than A, they are asking. Not possible. My remainder is always should be, the divisor is zero. For this divisor, this number should be coming to the less than number. Then only we can stop the division. Any table if you take, for example, if you are taking 4 table, if you are reaching 3, we will stop this division. Because this number is smaller than this number, we will be saying like that. The remainder value should be less than my B value or it can be 0. That is, this is the correct one. Remainder can be equal to 0 or more than 0, but that should be compulsory less than B. That is a correct condition that you have to give. We'll look at the third problem now. A and B when divided by 4 and 6. So we are dividing A by 4 and we are dividing B by 6. Now what they are given is remainder, leaving the remainder P and Q respectively. So in this division we are getting the remainder P and this division we are getting the remainder as Q. Now what is the maximum value of P and Q? What is the maximum value of P and Q they are asking? So maximum they are asking now. Since here the division is doing with 4. So what are all the number can be possible for the remainder? That remainder can be 0, 1, 2 or 3. Only these 4 numbers are possible for when we are doing with 4 table. Here the remainder can be from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to 5 it is possible. Here they are asking you the maximum number. Here in this division my maximum number is 3. During this division my maximum number is 5. So maximum remainder will be 3 plus 5 will give you 8. So 8 is your correct answer. We'll move on to the next problem now. So this is our fourth question. Which one cannot be the square of any natural number they are asking? So we have a very simple rule. By looking at the unit digit, we can decide which number will not be a square number. Look at this one. So the number is ending with 1 can be a perfect number. So the number which is ending with can be a square of some other number. So we cannot take this. The number ending with 5 also can be a square of any number. That also we cannot take. The number ending with 4, that also can be a square of any number. That also we cannot take. Here look at the unit digit. Unit digit is 2. Look at all the perfect square number. It will be never ending with 2. So the best, very important rule is, the number which is ending with 2, 3, 7 and 8 will never be a perfect number. Never be a square number also. Never be a perfect number, that you just keep it in your mind. Here my unit digit is 2. So that is not a perfect number. This is not a square of any other number. That is your answer. We'll move on to the next problem now. If the number 91876x2 completely divisible by 8, then the smallest whole number in the place of x will be what they are asking. So they have given us this whole number is divisible by 8. Divisible by 8 means we have a divisibility rule for 8. Divisibility rule of 8 is nothing but last 3 digit of the given number should divisible by 8. Then only we can say that the whole number will come in this 8 table. So look at the last 3 digit here. 6, x and 2. So we have to take that 6, that x and 2 should come in 8 table. If this number is coming in 8 table means the whole number will come in 8 table. We can say that we have to go by the trial and error method only. But look at the first option, we are getting 1. Just write the 1 here. So after writing 1, 8 sevens are 56. So again subtraction 52. 52 will not come in 8 table. So this is not possible. We are not getting 0. So 612 will not come in 8 table, we can say. Look at the next option, we are getting 3. So take it 3 again. 8 sevens are 56. The remainder we are getting 7. Next number is 2. And 8 nines are, it will be 72. We are getting the 0. So if you are substituting 3 in this place, this number is divisible by 8. So the whole number also will divisible by 8, we can say. So 3 is your correct answer. So which of the following is irrational is our question. So irrational, first the definition is irrational means that should be a non-terminating, that is non-ending, and as well as non-recurring number, non-repeating and non-terminating number, that is called irrational number actually. So which is satisfying this condition, that will be called as a irrational number. So this is a repeating number, it cannot be irrational, this will come under rational number. 0.2 the whole square, it will be a terminating one. 0.2 into 0.2, we can write it as 0.04, it's over. That is also a rational number only. Look at this, that last one, 10.2, it is a terminated one. It's over, this division is, this decimal is over, that is also rational. Look at this, 3.14159, this is nothing but the value of pi. It is a non-terminating as well as non-recurring number. This is a irrational number. That is the correct answer. We'll move on to the next one now. So this is the next problem. T is called an irrational number. So T is an irrational number if it cannot be written in the form of dash and P and Q are integer, then what is the one more condition they are asking. Children, we know that irrational means that is a non-terminating and non-recurring. Then one more definition also we can say, irrational, the number which is not a rational number. Not a rational number will be called as an irrational number, we can say that. Not a rational numbers will be called as an irrational number also, we can say that. So we all know that what is the condition for rational number, right? So here what cannot be the condition they are asking? Which condition is not suitable for irrational number they are asking? Definitely rational number condition will never satisfy for irrational. So look at all the options, which is the definition for rational number. So P by Q, P is not equal to 0 is given, that is wrong. Denominator should not be equal to 0, that is the correct answer. Second one is given in multiplication. Look at the third option. P by Q, Q is not equal to 0. This is a definition for the rational number. This cannot be the condition for the irrational. You have to pick up the term which should not be a condition for irrational. This cannot be the condition for the irrational because this is a condition for a rational number. That's all, students. Thank you for watching. If you like our video, subscribe our channel for more videos.